So if we just start.
My name is Nicholas Charles Flower, and I'm developing the digital technology for data analysis. Brief introduction of myself.
This is my brief introduction. My research area is database and data mining and data engineering. And also, I'm working on cloud computing and web information systems and e-science. So this is the outline of my talk. First, the era of big data. And the next is a fundamental introduction of database systems. And after that, I talk about data-centric and cloud computing. And next, big data processing and trend of research and development. So this is a so interesting question. So already the answer is appeared here, but top company is computer industry. In 1970s to 1980s, the most popular company in the computer area is IBM. They are making computer hardware. And 1980s, the Microsoft is the top company. They are making software, so operating system, Windows operating system. And 2000, the most major company was Google. They are collecting data in the web and also another data sources and provide information to the users. And currently it is difficult to say one company, but usually it is said that AGFA, A is Apple, and G is Google, and F is Facebook, and another A is Amazon. So the trend is changing. So from 2000, from year 2000, the data is a king. And currently, these services are also making a lot of data and provide the information to the users and collecting information from the users. So basically, this is a data world. Okay. So what is the reason of such kind of big data? First reason is reduction of the storage cost. So currently, it is very easy to store big data because currently you can buy 2 terabyte hard disk drive less than 10,000 yen, 1 man yen. Okay, so consider that one newspaper. Okay, is so in the morning newspaper, it contains about 500 kilobyte of data, okay, of in characters. So 1 terabyte disk can hold about 55,000 years of newspapers. Okay, so the price is very, and also consider that 1 terabyte disk can store about 250,000 songs. So the price is 0.02 yen per song. It is very, very cheap. And this trend is still continuing. So that it means that we can store non-necessary data because it is very time-consuming to organize data and clean up the storage. So we can leave the data as is. Okay. So based on the reduction of the storage cost, many services can be enabled. For example, Gmail, Dropbox, and Instagram, they provide the services without any cost. Okay. It is based on one reason of the services a reduction of the storage cost. This figure shows the explosion of the web. So number of websites is increasing. Y-axis is number of websites from 2000 and 2024. Okay. So the explosion of web can be summarized here. So statistics is still old, but probably it makes sense. Number of websites is 759 million. So very, very big. And total data on the internet is in the year of 2013, it is larger than 1 yottabyte. So yottabyte means that, so the byte, kilobyte, and megabyte, gigabyte, terabyte, petabyte, exabyte, zettabyte, yottabyte, okay? Currently, the data size is the order of yottabyte. And also, currently, web is getting larger and larger because they contains many additional contents, such as moving pictures and for example, YouTube, and also many pictures as in Instagram. Okay. And so surprisingly, Google only has indexing 0.34% of web pages, very limited percentage of the web, total web. Okay. And so we have so many, a huge number of the hidden website, called as invisible web or deep web. It means that so we can see the surface of the web using search engine like Google, but it contains in the behind of the web. So for example, we can search the Amazon.com by some queries. Behind that, we have so many data. The data set in the Amazon can be obtained by making queries, but it is not shown directly. Okay? Such kind of data is called deep web. Deep web includes such kind of commercial site, but also includes government and undetected sites. And also, for example, this is the example of Wikipedia. Wikipedia also contains some data behind the site. Okay. And also today, the difference from the 2000 to 2010s is we are currently increasing the number of sensing devices. For example, if you go to convenience store or supermarket, you can see that POS system, POS system, it calls the point of sale system. When something is sold, it is directly transferred the information to the servers. Okay, so usually what is purchased and what is the date and the time and the profile of the person who bought the items, for example, age, sex, etc. Okay, it can be used for some inventory management and advertisement and promotion. So this is very popular these days. For example, 7-Eleven convenience store, it has 20,000 stores in Japan. Okay, each store collects 4,000 POS entries per day. Okay, and probably it is usually 3 to 4 gigabyte each day, and in total 40 to 50 terabyte in a day. Okay, so it is the data is every day the data is sent to the servers, and it is collected and stored and analyzed for the some kind of the trend analysis and making some strategies. So in the various areas, sensor data is available. So for example, GPS and car navigation, and a mobile phone, and a video camera, and healthcare devices, and many applications. And we also have IC tags and RFID tags. So if you go so shopping, IC tag is attached in the, for example, if you go to the CD shop, IC tag is attached to the CD. And if you go to gate, without payment, it is detected. So it's a kind of a sensor devices. And in the smallest one is very, very tiny one. This is a, this one point is IC tag. It contains some kind of information. For example, some digit numbers. So it can be used for detecting some information in the the tag is attached to the some items, and we can detect the information of using some the IT tags. Okay. And recently, another topic has appeared: Internet of Things (IoT). IoT means everything can be connected by to the internet, not only human. It means that every devices, for example, mobile phone, and also audio devices and TV. And this is, what is this? This is maybe video camera, and also car, and this is equipment, and for example, video camera. So everything can be connected into the internet, and we can monitor everything in the world. So recently, the trend is changing. So data was originally made by human, but these days the trend is changing, and the data is made by devices and also some sensor systems. So the number of the devices is also increasing. So the data is also, the large volume of data appeared. Okay. This is another figure of the big data. InfoProjo project was held in Japan 4 years ago. Okay, this figure shows that the illustration of the information explosion from the from recent years. Okay, so initial one is 40,000 years ago, a cave painting. Okay, after that, year 105. Paper appeared, and after that, we have the human, so generate some kind of information. But the amount of information is limited. But after 2000, year 2000, the amount of information is so exploding. Okay. It estimates 35 zettabytes, but as I said before, the amount of the web site is already considered as more than yottabyte. So the speed is now increasing. Okay. And so we are in the age of big data. And what is a big data? Big data is a buzzword since 2010. And usually, it is called 3V is important. Volume, so it has large volume. And also V, variety, okay, and velocity, so very high speed of data. And we have two kinds of big data. It is very important to distinct two kinds of big data. One type of big data is inside of existing database, well-organized database. For example, company's employment salary or your education scores, it is organized and stored in database. And another one is outside of database. So it is very heterogeneous. For example, web and sensor data, they are very heterogeneous and dirty. Okay. So and the feature of such kind of data is each data item is not so important. For example, one element of GPS trajectory is not so quite interesting. But if we collect the trajectory of 10,000 people, it makes sense. Okay. We can extract some kind of information from the trajectories. So these days, we have to consider some kind of the how to use effective use of the big data. So we need some kind of big data processing. For example, Google, this data is very old, but 2008, Google process 20 petabytes per day. Okay? And eBay is a shopping site. They process 9 petabyte user data and 50 terabyte per day. And Facebook also process 36 petabyte user data. And also another kind of data, this is Serum. This is an accelerator. It is not related with this scenario. And Amazon also process many kinds of data requests. Okay. So the data management and the data processing is very important. So next, we go to the foundation of database systems, the trend, the traditional one. First, consider that this is an example of Amazon.com. We can see that book information, and we can make query. We can make issue some kind of keyword-based queries. And behind that, we have the database management system, which care about the query processing. And what is a database system? Database system integrates and stores and manages the data resources in various applications. And they provide effective sharing and high-level use of data. The example is website, very popular, and also management of student records. And database, database system and database are different. Database system is a system, and database is a data, okay? Data is managed data, persistently managed and well-organized data sets for shared use in multiple applications. So shared use is very important, okay? And this figure shows a very simple illustration of the database system. For example, this is a data maintained by Amazon, okay? Amazon.com. And we have database systems here. But to organize big data, we need some kind of software for ease of the management. Okay, so the role of the such kind of management is usually based on database management system, DBMS. DBMS is very important software these days. It is used in any kind of web applications. Okay, so usually web system is created like this. For example, usually we can use a personal computer or a mobile phone in the web browser. Okay, then and the request goes through the internet and arrive at the web server. For example, Amazon.com web server. They receive that query and they translate the request to the based on the backend application system, and queries transferred to application server. It implements application specific tasks. Okay? And the data used in the application server is maintained by DBMS. Okay? Based on the request, DBMS retrieves the required data from the database and provides to the application server. Also, application server may issue some kind of to store the new data. Okay? And in that case, DBMS stores the new arrived data. Okay, next is relational database and SQL language. So currently, how database is organized is basically based on the relational data model. It is very popular, and most of the database systems are based on relational data model. It is a conceptually, it manages the set of tables. For example, consider the CD shop, okay, web CD shop. Each data set is represented by the table. First one is CD table. It contains CD ID, artist, title, and price. And next one is client, client ID, name, and email. And sales is date, CD, and this is a CD ID, okay? And this is a client ID. So it means that in October 10th, this CD is bought by this client, okay? And another table shows that the stock information. The CD one is stocked in the Tokyo area, and the number of the item is 322, okay? So in the relational data model, every data set is represented by a set of tables. And the next is how to use, so how to query such kind of data. The standard of data query is, data query language is called SQL, SQL. SQL is a language for manipulating relational database. And it was a very old language proposed in 1970s, but still expanding based on the usage, because the usage of database is expanding, the standards are also expanding. So if you learn the SQL, we can write high-level database manipulation. We can provide, manipulate database in high-level concept. And also, if we learn SQL, it can be used in any kind of database system. For example, Oracle, Microsoft SQL Server, IBM DB2, and PostgreSQL. Okay? So you don't have to need different languages. So example of SQL, it's a very simple query. We select the data from the one table. Okay? In this case, from CD table, where is the condition? The artist name is Beatles, and we select CD ID and the title. In this case, from the database, it is extracted. This table is extracted. Okay, you can understand. Next one is a kind of, it contains joining two tables. In this case, we consider two tables, CD and stock. And CDID, this means that this condition means that the, it says that CDID of CD table and CDID of stock table should be the same. And artist should be the Beatles. So in this case, we connect this row and this row, okay? And this row and the next row because 0001, okay? And this ID3 is also joined to this one, okay? Then after that, we make selection and extract columns. And finally, the result of this table is obtained, okay? So based on the this query, we can combine the multiple tables. So this is a very simple application of SQL language. And why this database is needed, actually used? First one is, it's very complicated, but it allows independence of application from data management. So we don't have to care about the detail of the data, so how data is stored or something. Okay. And another one is management of consistency, because the database usually checks some errors. So we don't have to care about the detail of the consistency management. And another important one is access control. So for example, a lecturer can see the score of the student, but the student can see only his or her score, okay? We can, using the database, we can control the access, user access to the data items. And another one is very important, efficient query execution. So current database is very efficient. For example, if you issue some query to Amazon.com, it can return the results within 1 second. It is very quick. Okay. Currently, the DBMS is very efficient for making some kind of query processing. Another one is concurrent access from multiple users. So concurrent access means that, for example, one user is querying the data, another user is updating the same data, okay? So we can, it is very difficult situation, but DBMS automatically controls such kind of conflict and manages concurrent access in the safe way. Another one is cope with is system failures. For example, outage of electricity. It is very difficult situation. In such a case, DBMS can automatically recover from the log information. Based on the log information and also some kind of additional information, the DBMS can recover from the based on the old state and current up-to-date state. So the query processing is the most interesting part. For example, consider that Amazon.co.jp, it has 5 million items, even for the book, okay? And, but they should provide the query processing within 0.2 seconds because they need to return answers within, for example, 1 second. But it contains the network transfer delay, okay? So the target is 0.2 seconds. So basically, why it is possible? So basically, it provides a construction of indexes. And also query plan construction. So they consider how to execute query when it is given. Okay. This is an image of indexing. To accelerate the query, so the condition is the Beatles, So we initially create index beforehand. So from this database, we extract the contents of information and create the index. For example, the Beatles, the artist Beatles appeared in CDID 1 and 2. And Eric Clapton is appeared in number 3. So if we have such kind of data, when this query is issued, we first search this index. The Beatles, oh, OK, this Beatles. The Beatles appeared in CD 1 and CD 2. So in this case, we extract two CDs information quickly. Okay. Basically, such kind of indexing and another kind of query processing techniques makes the quick data query processing. So another one is so concurrency control. Concurrency control is, so this is a very typical situation. So this is administrator. He want to add 1,000 new CDs in the stock. Okay, and she is buying the new CD. Okay, two requests are issued in the same time. So the problem happens. For example, this is an example of a transaction. This is a administrator's transaction. Read current number of stock numbers. And after that, 1,000 is added to the stock. And after that, number of stock is write back, okay, written back. And this is another transaction by user. So the user reads the current number of stock. And after that, because she bought one CD, the number of stock is decreased, okay, decremented. And the amount is write back. In this case, the real one is so initially assume that we have 5,000 stocks. If we run the correct data processing process, finally the amount is 5,999 is correct. But if the execution of the transaction is so overlapped, in this case, wrong result 6,000 is obtained. Okay, it is a failure of transaction. In current database system, we can manage such kind of the we can safely exclude such kind of the illegal update or two update. Usually, transaction A is executed, so transaction B wait after the save point. And after that, transaction B is executed, or transaction B is executed before transaction A. Okay? So database system automatically manages such kind of concurrent execution of updates. Okay. Oh, last 5 minutes. Okay. Currently, the situation is changing. And also, we have the big data processing system. For example, this is Google. Google has data, many data data centers. And it contains each devices here. Is a server, okay? And in a big building, the many kind of computers are in this, the stored and processed, okay? Okay, skip data center. And the importance of query cloud computing is, okay, skip here. The importance of data center is they can provide more flexible data processing because they have many computers and request comes frequently from different applications. They can provide the services for every customers. And if the request is large, for example, in the summer bargain sale period, the request is increasing. And also December, Christmas season, also the request to the shop is increasing. Okay. Usually, without the data center, we have to provide, for example, department store provide own data providing services. In that case, they have to consider the max to serve maximum capacity of the resources. Okay, then it is very difficult to provide the it is very difficult to provide so for very crowded period. But the currently, if we use data center, based on the request, we can assign additional resources by requesting the data center. So based on that, we can safely adapt to the increase of capacity and decrease of capacity. Okay. So the currently, the important thing is called scale up and scale out. Is two notions is very important. Scale up means improve performance with a powerful server. This is a traditional one. So use, for example, use of faster CPU. It can process the data in an efficient way. But recent years, it is more important to scale out features. It means that if we add additional server, for example, we add 10 additional servers, we can increase the processing power. It is called scale out. It is called horizontal scaling. So the cloud computing is basically the principle of cloud computing is scalability. So we can add any resources for the efficient processing of data. And also availability. Availability is when the failure occurs, we can adapt in the safe way. Okay. It's a principle of cloud computing. Okay. And we have no time. Another one is, let's skip this. Okay. Currently, the data processing is written this figure. Existing traditional database system is here. Traditional data, and usually not so low level, but very low level analysis. And after that, data warehouse is kind of analysis of data. This is a traditional database system, but currently in the big data era, we have another kind of data processing system. For example, Hadoop provides data processing system for big data in the low level. And we have currently new system for data warehousing for big data appear. And the trend is the high-level analysis is very important, for example, using machine learning and AI techniques. And for the traditional data sets, we can also process data analytics, but also new kind of data, big data, so data analytics is very important. Okay. So the current trend is database and machine learning are integrated in a clear way and provide some kind of new applications. Okay. So I will skip this. Probably this time up. So I summary this one. Okay. Okay, summary of my talk is currently the error of big data and database system is traditionally, database system is very important, but currently integration with machine learning and big data is very important. Okay, thank you very much. So if you have questions,